I think it's pretty safe to say that one big controversy about Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker was the return of Emperor Palpatine and how that sort of had a big impact on Anakin's sacrifice at the very end of Return of the Jedi. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars content. Now, here we are in the very beginning of 2020, and as we look ahead into the future, we do know that Disney and Lucasfilm are looking for ways in order to reunite the fans and to also create a successful Star Wars franchise, not just with movies and TV shows, but also for the franchise in its entirety. We are talking about this new universe that they are currently developing as we speak that's going to consist of movies, TV shows, both in live action and animated form, books, novels, comics, video games, and so on and so forth. That's really going to all connect to each other and will be modeled after the MCU and how that has worked and has been very successful. So when you look at Disney Star Wars, obviously a lot of fans had a major issue with one aspect of The Rise of Skywalker, and that was, of course, the death of Emperor Palpatine. Now, granted, some of you out there may very well be satisfied with Palpatine's death and how he died. I myself had a major issue with Palpatine's demise at the very end of Episode 9, not just because of how fast it really happened, but also because of how predictable it really was. Now, when you look at everything related to what Kathleen Kennedy did, she really did interfere with a lot of the creative decisions by J.J. Abrams and Chris Terrio and what they originally wanted to do with Palpatine. We've gone over that before in the past. And what's really intriguing about all of this is that now that both Disney and Lucasfilm are finished with the Skywalker saga, they are moving on to their new Star Wars universe, as well as their new Star Wars trilogy of films, where it's noted that currently Disney is coming up with a plan to reunite the fans around the world, to create a more acceptable Star Wars franchise for the community, and they are trying their best to reunite the fans, where it's said that Lucasfilm is currently developing a series of stories that will retcon both, of course, The Last Jedi and The Rise of Skywalker in various ways for the fans, and that they are trying to enhance the film experience. One of the big plans by Lucasfilm is that Dave Filoni will be on board for one of the stories for the new Star Wars universe that is going to retcon Palpatine's death in The Rise of Skywalker to expand Palpatine's demise in the story, where it's noted that Disney recognized that fans had an issue with Palpatine's quick and predictable death in The Rise of Skywalker, and that their new story that they are working on is set to release sometime in 2021 that will retcon Palpatine's death by the hands of Rey in a major way, and that Dave Filoni is going to be working on this with Jon Favreau as well as for the new Star Wars universe. Now, it's noted that this may be in the form of a book, novel, or comic, however, that is currently unclear, but what is clear is that Disney wants to make it known to the majority of fans of exactly how Palpatine really died and by Palpatine's enhanced death in the new Star Wars universe that will refresh the ending of Episode 9 for many of the fans around the world. Now, this is Disney's attempt to retcon a major aspect of the film, and that they also plan to retell Palpatine's death at the very end of Return of the Jedi. So, the thing that's really interesting about this is that this really seems like that Disney is very desperate when it comes to how the fans perceive the character of Palpatine surviving at the very end of Episode 6, or should I say dying and coming back to life, and how what they plan to do now with Palpatine's death at the very end of Episode 9 is that they're trying to retcon it. Basically, what they want to do is they want to really enhance, they want to expand Palpatine's death by the hands of Rey in The Rise of Skywalker, and exactly, specifically, what really killed him in secret. Now, there's more to the story, and that's what the new Star Wars universe is going to answer. This is all going to be told sometime in 2021. Thankfully, the upcoming novelization, which, by the way, is due for release in March of this year, is going to explain exactly how Palpatine survived the fall at the very end of Episode 6, or how he came back to life, if you will, and it's going to be an interesting thing. Now, Dave Filoni, like I say, he is the man. I mean, George Lucas worked very well with Dave Filoni, and he pretty much, you know, worked closely with him for the Clone Wars seasons 1 through 6, and now that Season 7 is back on the table, you know, I'm just so happy to see that it's back here and that Dave Filoni is back with the Star Wars universe and the franchise. And the one thing that really did bother a lot of fans, though, was, of course, Palpatine in The Rise of Skywalker and how he died by the hands of Rey, you know, saying, "And I am all the Jedi," and how the Force Ghosts of the past essentially help bring Rey back up, bring her back up on her feet to face her grandfather and to destroy him once and for all. So the fact that they're going to retcon this, I'm not quite sure how significant the retcon really will be. Obviously, there's more to the story here when it comes to the spirits of the Sith and stuff around those lines. We also know that that's going to be explained in the upcoming novelization, everything with Palpatine saying of how all the Sith live in him. That's going to be fully explained to the fans in the upcoming novelization, and I will make sure to cover that for those of you that don't want to pick up the book or have no interest in the novelization. I will be covering all of that as we go along. So, like I said, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know anything about all this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.